The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman on this ninth day of June. And we're looking at the Dow down 300 at 27,269. Yesterday, I think at this time, we were looking at a plus 300 and closed up sharper than that. This is very interesting. Why? Because when we get to a leg D in the ChapmanWave methodology, especially when we are either at or approaching highs for whatever instrument we're looking at, that's where we get a little bit cautious. And yeah, we are in leg D, probably going to make a peak D today because I can't see anything to turn the market around to go above the 27,580 level of yesterday. But look at the strength of the MACD, the moving average convergence divergence. Look at the strength of the unbalanced volume. Yes, it's dipped. I said yesterday it's a little choppy. We should get a bit of a pullback. But look at the stochastic at 95.65%. It's flat and steady. So what would it take to get some kind of a sell signal to sell mode in the daily chart? It would probably take a dip to test, or probably, I'd say, because at 95% to get the stochastic below 80% from this level, to get this green fast-moving average of the 9-period exponential moving average and the black 14-period moving average to cross negative and then go under the 200-period moving average of 25,657, I would say that to get a sell mode, in other words, something that says, watch out, now we're in trouble, you'd have to see probably underneath a close underneath 25,000. So that's over 2,200 points from here. Now, it either does that in one fell swoop, or it takes a period of time to start to see these technicals, these technical tools, that is, start to deteriorate. And that's kind of what I'm thinking. At the same time, when you get, and I'll go through these one at a time. In fact, let me do that now. When you get the QQQ, the NDX 100, at an all-time high, I mean, it's hard to believe, right? An all-time high in one of the indexes in the market when we know that businesses, so many businesses have either failed or aren't going to be able to come back. We know the unemployment rate is going to be very high. How on earth could this be? And we know that the history of the market is to look at the stock market and say, it's a forward-looking instrument. It's telling us not what's happening now. That's why economists for decades, I've heard economists talk about whatever it is they're looking at, but they have a look-back period. They have no choice. Economists, by the very nature of the means with which they get the important information, data-driven. But it's data-driven on the history. Up until this very second, they look back. Then they speculate on looking forward, but it's all on backward data. And that's the reason why the stock market is such a beautiful instrument. It's real time, and it takes us to a place that is, maybe you can say forward-looking, because sometimes it's forward-looking, but it doesn't see, like in February, it didn't see that big smash to the downside, 39% for the Dow, 30% for the QQQ. But it is in many ways a forward-looking instrument in terms of anticipation. When anticipation and reality meet, we sometimes get something different. And I think we're getting closer to that. There's no question that many stocks are getting overbought. There's no question that there's a whole slew of these little tiny things that are going from 70 cents to $2.30 or from $3 to $30. It's just unbelievable. And that's the kind of speculation I don't like to see. It's very nice to be participating in if you are, but it is not great for the market because it's the late stage of some kind of a big move. All right, so with that said, QQQ is all-time high trading at 243.02. Leg F, unless I have to renotate this, and that's a possibility, but that's I have to tell you, this is a spectacular move. MACD is very strong. Stochastics at 94.69%. On balance volume is getting a little bit overbought. Relative strength, look at this gray line right here. Relative strength is really good. It's up at just over 70%. I don't know, not too much to complain about there. IWM, Russell 2000 lagging. Today it's down 315, down 2.05%. 149.93, made a high yesterday of 153, wasn't it? Let me just check. 153.39, let me just type that in so we've got some reference point that I can keep coming back to. 153.39, there we go. Not a slash, but a dot. Okay, 0.39. So, had a fabulous move, getting a little tired in terms of the notation because this is at a peak D, but the weekly chart is already at a leg D, and that says, you know, usually after D you can get some kind of a bit of a pullback, but the MACD and the daily is very strong. Stochastic at 93%, on balance volume is very good, and the relative strength has dipped a little bit. It's just under 70% right now, and the daily, the weekly chart is starting to improve tremendously. And the month, I haven't spoken about monthly charts. Probably I'll do that tomorrow. I'm not going to take time today because we do have to wait for a couple of things to happen. And I missed the S&P, didn't I? Yes, SPX, right, yeah, SPX.X. 32.33 was the high yesterday. Today it's trading at 32.06, down 25. Hey, after the move yesterday, this is nothing. We can even have another 2 days like this, and it'll still say ho-hum. Not ho-hum if that 31.20 green 9-period exponential moving average is hit in the next 2-3 days. That'll be a sign to say, whoops, we're starting the rollover. I don't think we're quite there yet. I think there's still internal strength. All right, enough with that. Let's just go on. I had a question about the VIX. Let's have a look at the VIX. VIX index is up. It's at 27.19, up $1.37 at 27.18. Now, we have not seen anything like this, where there's been such a spectacular move, and the VIX index, which went to 85.47 on the 18th of the Friday before the Monday low in the market, on the Friday in the down in the S&P, and that says that 85.47 down to 27.19 right now, that is a huge decline. But to tell you the truth, I'm not sure if I'm going to have to start changing the whole parameters for my VIX index. Remember, I had the whole, even had part of a webinar once where I discussed all the numbers that I've been using for years. Under 12 is very bullish. Between 12 and 14, it starts to say you're getting kind of bullish. In the mid-teens, 15 to 17, it's very bullish. You're going to the, why am I saying bullish? Sorry, going into from the 13 to the 16s, that starts to say, be careful, you can have intraday 100-point declines in the Dow, double-digit in the S&P, but you could still close up. But once you get into the 19 and 20s, that says, watch out, triple-digit declines and closing at the low is likely, and you're starting to get close to some kind of a turn. But this was the coronavirus thing said, set us on fire. It went all the way to 85.47 and is still holding extremely strongly. Now, I don't know whether those levels are all going to have to be bumped up. We'll know in a month. I'm not going to say sooner than that. And if we do get into the teens in the next couple of weeks, that'll really say, hey, we've set back to what we used to be. Otherwise, we're going to have to use the term that everyone uses right now, a new normal. We'll be looking at a new normal. The Dow's down 259, S&P's down 25. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, love to take your calls, and we've got a couple of questions coming in right now.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, folks. So let's look at gold. Gold is up 18 at 1723. As I said before, I think gold is in play. You've got to understand that these sell-offs are just part of the ritual that we find with gold, that it has really big moves, and then it can take quite a while just to consolidate, and all each one of these becomes a high level consolidation before it breaks out again. This one, I think, has the potential to test the 1650 to the 1620 area. And that's going to be big, because if it breaks under 1620, I think the consolidation actually lasts a lot longer. And one of the reasons is because it's in a peak D in the monthly chart, and that's usually where you can get more time. It doesn't have to be price, but it certainly could be time. And it'll be spectacular action if gold at any point in the next 2 weeks is able to trade just even as a spike. It doesn't even have to hold there, but a close, a spike into the 1850 area on the continuous contract is a 1723. It's not even 100 points. But let's just say 100 points up from here would be really, really good action. I'm thinking this goes a little bit longer. Let's just see what silver's doing here. SI, silver's down 0.05 at 17.83. Yeah, it tells me just needs a breather before it can really leap above this Chapman Wave inside track repellent zone in the down channel, the falling X pattern. And here again, silver made a high of 18.95. Yeah, 18.95 the week of the June the 5th. That was last week. And what we're looking at, if there is a push in silver to the 19.55 area, let me just double check on that. Yeah, 19.55. A close, this has to be a close, above 1955, I think that's going to be a good sign, and that could actually lead gold higher. So that's that, and I just wanted to show you the dollar trying to rally. It's just been acting very poorly. I showed this yesterday. I said it's trying to come off a low, but 90, what did I say the price was? 96.30 is the level to watch for the 1-2-1-2, the downside propeller shaft pattern. Well, today it's gone down to 96.23. In a leg F, unless it's recycled, A, B, C, it could be G slash C. Yeah, this is, got to watch this closely. And what I said is, I think that the 200 period moving average in the weekly chart, 95, 92, because of the weekly chart's very negative technicals, I think that's going to have to be tested, even if there is a bounce. Okay. And just real quickly, EUR, just ask if I could look at some currencies. EUR, USD, 1.135 for the euro dollar currency pair. Looks good. It's going to try to tackle that leg D that was peak D that was made 3 days ago. 1 point, if I can ever read these things, 1.3838. Oh, that's nice. And now what we're looking at is the USD JPY, the yen, dollar yen currency, went to peak A, B, and then failed at a peak C because it's plummeted quite sharply. 107.67, down 0.77. Yeah, like the dollar, it's just kind of struggling here. I just need to look at the crude oil and bonds, and then we're on our way. Crude oil peak G slash C. I think it's actually a C in that it's going to make another spike to a leg D, trading at 37.98, down 22 cents. So the question I had yesterday or the day before, USO, it's the same sort of thing. It's an alternate count, F slash B. Still, technicals are very good. I think there's enough room to have a little bit of a bounce coming up. And I said I'd look at the TLT. The TLT is trading up. Whoa, look at that. Big move up. 158.99 up 2.28. Right there. I didn't even see that because it gapped up. And it hit the 14-period moving average. So what I was saying yesterday is I think we could see somewhat of a rally in the bonds. But then I suspect that they're going to come back down and that at some point we'll get closer to the 150.79 200 period exponential moving average. That has to be modified if there is a close above the 160.64 14-day exponential moving average. If there's a close in the 161 area now instead of later, that'll say, you know what, we've raised the base. And then the question came up, do I think that the TLT's made a significant low? Looking at that weekly chart, I still think this is the H to a lowercase m pattern, and that we're going to still be coming down with yields going a little bit higher over a couple of weeks. So we'll see if that works out. Then I had a question, would I look at TTI? What was the question? Hi, Basil, could you take a look at TTI today on your show? Thanks. Yeah. So TTI is Tetra Technologies. So this is going to be, oh, is the break coming up? I want to do something during the break. I'll do it right now. Tetra. So T-E-T-R-A. And I'm going to put in something else here. And you're going to see something so interesting. So my daughter and I, it's a Tetra. Yeah, so my daughter and I, years ago, are going to we're going to the photographic exhibition. She was in when she was in high school. She was star for photography. She got the award for Newton North High School for photography and some other things, but photography. And she was very keen. So I took her to this show out in Burlington, one of the Hiltons or something. They always used to have this. And I'm driving in, and I look, and I see this tiny little car, and I say to my daughter, oh, look at that little Fiat. And then I said, oh, my God, that's a Citroen. And then we get out of the car to look at these things, and there's a guy. I look around, and I see this car. It looks something like this, but it was this mottled green, really a beautiful green color. See that? A little fin at the back. So we walk up to him. And then he talks to Captain, whatever his name is. He starts telling us about the car. This is the car that was used in the James Bond movie. And it gets shot, and there's still a hole in the window right here. And he shows us, and he's from Canada, and he's down here to show the car off. And it's the show is just a whole lot of information. A Tatra, that's what it was called. Tatra 77, 1933, the world's first production aerodynamic car. That wasn't the story. The story was, what they did, I think it was in Czechoslovakia. Czechoslovakia, let's see where the car's from. The world's production aerodynamic car. It's there in the background. So what happened was they used to, in 1939, 1940, 41, they used to have people who were fleeing from Germany, They would cross the border in this car with vegetables and stuff, as if they were farmers. And then they would come back, and right here, the engine was at the back, right between the engine and the back seat. It must be so hot. They used to put in a couple of people fleeing from Nazi Germany. And they would cross the border, and they did. They never got found out. They did this over and over. And that car was involved in it. So that was a Tatra, except it wasn't a T-E-T-R-A. It was a T-A-T-R-A. Anyway, Tatra Technologies, 0.6968, down 0.07. What do I think? I think this is in play. This is for only people that understand the speculative nature of something that you're paying 0.69, less than a dollar, just a little bit more than half a dollar. So if you're in this, I wouldn't get carried away, but what I would do is intraday. If it starts to rally, it's at 0.69. If it can get to 0.73, I would add just a little bit, expecting that it was going to try in the next day or so to go above the high it was made at 0.7783. But I wouldn't do that until there's that little bit of a rally, because if it starts to slide and it goes down under 0.67, just be real careful. So hold off. If you're in it, don't.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, an essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hey folks, we're back. So this looks to me like there's enough room to rally for this little stock. I just wouldn't get too carried away. I don't like stocks that have a whole series of spikes and then they make, in this case, a peak D, and then they take forever to have another big rally. And the other thing about this is that this is a continuation of the MACD because it's flat. It didn't really dip very strong. So I do have a down arrow, and it did pull back really sharply percentage-wise. But normally I would have looked at this and say, yep, I could see another two peaks here, and then you've got to be really careful because that stochastic at 81 could very quickly go under 78%, and that would be a negative. So just be real careful. But as a quick trade, yes. As a longer-term buy, I don't know what they do. I have no Tetra Technologies. They're spelt with an E. I don't know. This is like a Tetra. This is the this is the one I wanted to show you. So this is in the color, but this is, I wonder if it's got all of them here. No, it doesn't. Oh, can I go back? Yes. So this is the color. Isn't this, what an unusual color with a big shark fin at the back there. Look at that. That's the Tetra. Tetra 87. So look at that, and you see the air, that's for the engine at the back. That's to allow air to come in, like, instead of the radiator. What you got here is the air coming through the sides, and as I say, a little space between there, that's where they would smuggle people, get them across the border. Tetra. All right, so that's that. And the next question I had was, let's see, I'm not sure if it was a question, but I'm going to do it anyway. APON. Am I typing in the right place? I don't know. APON. AP, what did I say? APDN. There it goes. There it is. Okay. This is why one, oh, Applied DNA Sciences. Didn't I look at this the other day? Let me just double check here. AXSM. I haven't looked at that. All right. So this is a very interesting stock, also 8.07, up 21 cents. This is Applied DNA Sciences, Inc. This is just in the, at 8.05, give it another day or two. Let's see if it can hold support at the 7.11 to 7.05 area. If it takes that out, it goes under 7, that's it. I don't want anything to do with it. Otherwise, it might be one that could be in play for a little bit of a bounce. Is this a volume stock? Yeah, it does 1 million shares, 500 shares. I prefer these very low price stocks. They have about 2-3 million shares. I don't want to be stuck with something I can't get out of. So anyway, I just wanted to say APDN came to my notice. When I look at it, 7.89, up 3 cents. I don't think it's quite ready yet, but it might be ready for a bounce. And what I would say is if it's able to go at 796, the high today is 903. I mean, that's huge percentage moves. If it's able to get to 908 to 911 in the next 2 days, I think it's made the turn. It will start moving higher. Next question I had was, would I look at Boeing? Yep, Boeing. Boeing is down 8 at 223. This is a peak D. There's no new high today. I think Boeing's getting a little tired, but I don't see any, just at the moment, I don't see a smash to the 180s. I do see a little bit of a pullback. And then if it's able in the next week, if the market's able to come back, and I think it should try at least to come back, and Boeing's able to hit 238, once it gets to 238, the 240 area becomes a magnet, but it's the 249.20 200 period exponential moving average that hasn't been hit since it made that peak D right on the 12th of February at 349. Had a little bit of a pullback. 349 goes to $89 round number. And so this is fantastic action for Boeing. It's a little extended, but I think it's going to be a lot extended over a couple of weeks in time. How it's able to hold in the 200s is going to be really important. But I kind of like what I'm seeing at this particular moment. VRTX, Vertex. This is a different Vertex. This is the pharmaceutical. Yeah, Vertex Pharmaceuticals. So this is very interesting. I spent some time trying to count this in the usual way, in the ChapmanWave methodology. This peak A, peak B, and then a peak C looked like everything was going for it, but then the technicals were failing, and then it pulled back. So I'm going to do this. I'm going to show you that there was a chance that there was an inside buy right here, right here. These are the most difficult because you have to go back and change things. Why? Because this low that was made in April, right here, April at 240.50 on the 8th of April. had the MACD still rising, the stochastic pulled back and then rose again, and that coincided exactly with the peak F with a very sharp pullback. Everything was fitting nicely, except you then went to peak A in the ChapmanWave. This doesn't happen often, but lately I've seen just enough to say, hey, there's a way to do this, and you're going to have to figure it out, because you don't want to be stuck at a peak C and everything's in order, and then you have a big turn down. This could still be a rogue wave spike going above the high that was made on May the 18th, it pops to 295.55, and then it plummets down. I mean, plummet, that's a big sharp drop, down to 254.41 on the 27th of May, and look what's happened. So it's trying to get going again. I'm just going to say to you, if I do this and I call that the low and I put my down arrow here, and I'm just, this is one of those where I have no choice. I have to go back and say, where could I have gone wrong? It means that this would have been A, B, F slash C. I should have put that in because it was a possibility. F slash C, alternate count, pulls back, and then we go to D and E. So that's the way I'm looking at the notation there. That's besides the point. Besides the point is not that we've got to ignore where it is. And the question is, what about it? Well, what about it says that the arch formation that we've just seen is something you usually see at a peak F or G. You make a top and you pull back, and then you just have two big moves that go to higher highs and the technicals are failing, and then it pulls back. But usually you come back and you retest the starting point. This has not done that. So Vertex Pharmaceuticals, therapies for cystic fibrosis, up 875 at 273.75, says, I am still in play. Now, I should have asked, what about it? I'm going to do the analysis. The person asking often has options. I don't know if you have options on this. All I'm going to say is, to be positive, you would need to see the stochastic turn from 37 to 43 or 47% in the next 2 days. You'd have to see the price go above 278 to 281. Then it puts it in this rectangle formation. Yeah, even though there's an arch formation, basically this is what we're looking at. It's just stuck like that. And that'll say, I wouldn't be doing options on a very short-term basis because it could just be stuck in this range for now. But if you are negative and you got puts expecting that the low that was made on the 27th of 254.41, you don't want to see today at all. You don't want to see up 9 points on a day like this, when everything was perfect for it to follow through to the downside. You would have to see it close. Today reverses, and it closes only up to 267. So it gives back a whole chunk of the points and then goes down sharply tomorrow. That would be perfect for a put. At this point, I just don't see anything. It's stuck in a range. All I can say, Vertex is not vertical. It is stuck in a range, going sideways. Hope that helps you. Up, Dow's up 232, and I'll be right back in a few minutes. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians Hour.
The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Directions Daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction Shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foresight Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Hi, folks, we're back. So AXSM is the symbol. 81.71 right now for $1.16, and it's called Axsome Therapeutics, Inc. So this is a patent that I often talk about. So you start off at a low, beautiful doji low back in March, and then it goes zoop, goes up. It goes from the 37, from the 35 area, it goes all the way to 71.60. Pulls back, comes all the way back to the 49 area, then starts a brand new A. Now remember, what I've done over the years is I've said that the low that's made is the low. So you've got to count every peak. So that even though that this looks like it shouldn't, you should restart your count here. No, that was the peak, and there's the next peak, there's the next peak. So he goes peak A, B, C, D very quickly, pulls back, and then gaps up on some news and screams up to 109.53 on the 27th, gives back a chunk of the candle, has a nice little play on the sideways move, and then breaks the low. So it's a whole series of descending lows in very small candles, considering how big the other candles were. So it makes lower highs and much lower lows. And that gives you both, it's kind of almost like a channel line, right? Right there. I don't take it from the top. What's the point? I'm obviously going to break it down. I take it from that right there, if you're looking at the charts on the 29th, from that high of April. And then it goes beautifully down, and right now it's testing the Chapman Wave Inside Track Repellent Zone. It's going to the upper part of it at 81.78. So that's the start. Then you want to look, the MACD is improving. It's just about across positive for the first time in a while. And the stochastic is rounding nicely to 32%, and the on-balance volume is acting well. So is relative strength. So that's saying this stock is looking good. If you look at the weekly charts, well, it might be looking good, but it's stuck in a range. Look at the monthly chart and say, hey, high-level consolidation, nice. So what we are looking at here, just make it real simple, in this particular pattern, especially when it looks like a channel, treat this as if it's going to break to the upside. Where would it go? Well, the first peak on the left side is the round number right there on the 18th of May of 89.00. And then if it takes that out, you go to the next one. So am I being too greedy looking for 101 target? Dan, I'm looking at this and I'm saying, just go one step at a time. We haven't even broken the resistance yet. I love the action over the last 3 days, especially with the market. It's almost market independent in a way. I love that. And it's in this tech, biotech sector. I love that. So yeah, I think this looks good at 81.60. All I would do is I'd have a two-point, I'd give it a little room, I'd give it a two-point stop if you wanted to start a position. If you're in the position, just watch it closely. What you really want to see is by Tuesday, by Thursday between 11 and 2 o'clock Eastern time, you want to see a nice pop into the 83.30 to maybe 83.50 area. If it does that, that's a very good sign, and just go step by step, because that becomes your support level. Hope that helped you. Okay. Oh, you have a monthly 200 on July 75 calls. So that gives you a good comfort factor. 75. You didn't say what month. Oh, July. Yeah, that's exactly what you want. You don't want June. You want July. Nothing to it. You just stay in your position. And so far, you've done very nicely. Good. I don't want to mess around with that. Good action. Next question I had was, where did it go? XMI. Have I updated my XMI? I don't think I have. A dollar XMI. No, it's not the XMI. It's the, what were we looking at? Sorry. Where did it go? Question. Could I look at Boeing. Oh, XLI. XLI is the S&P Select Industrial Spider Fund. This is a real, much more industrials than the Dow. Peak C. Now, I've got a couple of things that are at peak C, and I think they're going to go to a D. So I suspect that there should be one more pop to the upside, at least before we start to think of a consolidation. And that says that the high that was made in the XLI trading is 74.63, down $1.66 right now. The high of yesterday was 76.53. 76.54 starts leg D, and I think it will get there. It might take another day or so. I think this consolidation can last maybe another day. So if that's the case, what do you do at that point? Well, I'm just looking at it as an index. 71.35 is the 200-period moving average. That's my go-to line if I start to see a deterioration over the next few days going into the Friday close, because we could still get a D tomorrow even. Or Thursday, and then all of a sudden you're left with Friday and early next week to look at the weekly charts. So I like this. It's acting very well. And yes, Boeing is a big part of it, and Boeing is down today. So, yeah, it makes sense. I was asked if I would look at the airline index, and I keep forgetting jets. There we go. Jets. A. There we go. Starting point is right there, 11.25, 11.27. I have to include that, AB. So here we go again, AB, another A and another B, and then another, just a plain little A, and then another A and a B and a C and a D. So the Jets have made it. The Jets have made it to a peak D. I can't put a down arrow. I can only put a plus sign. It's getting close to the 200-period moving average. It's at 20.49. You know, what's going on with the throat? Let me just get this. All right, we got you there. So Jets trading U.S. Global Jets ETF, because it has Boeing in that. I'm going to say that it's had a stupendous move. It's broken all the support levels. Under 17.40, it takes a deeper consolidation. I don't think it's going to do that right now, so I wouldn't be surprised. If there's a little bit more room, it could go to the 22s. The high was just over 22 3 days ago. It's trading at 20.49 right now. This is just a leg A. Yeah, the weekly chart is improving. The MACD's got a nice turn-up signal, and the stochastic in the weekly is at 30.98, and the monthly chart hit the pink 9-period exponential moving average, and is now the resistance. What does this pop up here? Pop up IBD. The e-commerce leadership could be forming a new base too. All right, good. It's kind of the way I'm looking at it in the shorter term. Okay, just wanted to look at this in the meantime. I haven't had a chance to update it since my show. This is the E-mini 2-minute chart, peak A, peak B, What are we always looking for? At least a peak D, and then we've got to be a little careful. There's your peak D, E-mini, bi-mode in the two-minute chart. But the five-minute chart is only in the leg A. I've got to check. Yeah, leg A. Peak A, that is. Magd is good. Stochastic's way at 85%. I think there's a little more room to try to rally. If it doesn't break at 3208, it must hold 3205. Close in the next 20 minutes below 3205 says, you know what? We're going to be stuck in this lower range for the rest of the day. If there's a move into the 3216 area by, what are we, 10 to 1? By an hour's time, that'll say, hey, good, try to rally a little bit more into the close today. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Ignition Hour, Dow down 222. Who's that?
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006. And like many of you, was drawn in by, as well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us. And Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get the competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionics, oil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge heard here at TFNN.com.
Let's see. I'm just checking a couple of things here. Yes. Okay, so the question was, the statement in the den was, the bankrupt traders, the BK traders, that is the traders that are trying to trade these bankrupt companies, Jimmy says, are losing their touch. CHK reopens down 70%. So yesterday, I couldn't believe it. I mean, someone says CHK is trading up from the 23 area into the high 70s. I couldn't believe it. So there it is. Look at this gap. Island reversal in leg D. What happens at a peak D? You got to be careful. Why? Because you can go from the 70 level down to 23 in one breath. Look at that. So, yeah, be careful. This is a period I'm saying to subscribers, please. We have to be careful. We have to be very selective. We don't have to be greedy, but you don't want to get out of positions too soon. This is a very fine line, and I hope that we're able to tread it as carefully as possible. Some things are really working and still working. Oh, question in the den. What was that question? F-E-Y-E. Question in the den was... F-E-Y-E, Basil. Think we should add to this? No. So we have this position. We started a long position in 1199 in Fire Eye Inc. At 1199. That was on the 26th of May. It's sort of struggled, but what I was saying is if we can break this hole, this is the Chapman Wave restart. It's a beautiful example that once you break that rectangle sideways formation, you're kind of free to roam, and then you can go for the next level, like a 200-period moving average, which was the 1357. Today, it broke that. It's in leg E, and it's going to 1406. It's at 1394 right now. I like the fact that it's done this, Peaky. I think it's now in play. But I'm going to have to do some analysis because the MACD is strong. Stochastic's at 85%, so it has room to go. On balance, volume has room to go. This is a good sign. How we play it is going to be something very interesting. I might even think of an option trade. But anyway, this is very nice. Folks, I'll be back with Tom a little later on today. Stay tuned. You've got Steve, Dave, and Tom. And check out my opening call, my daily newsletter. Still remain long the down. We'll see how long that lasts. Have a great day. Otherwise, I'll see you later on with Tom. See you tomorrow.